Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on active learning techniques. So, in this lecture, I am going to explain few of the active learning techniques that we have to practice in the classroom delivery, and at the end, I have presented the problem based learning which is applicable for solving problem in the classroom. A case study I have presented at the end. So, these are all the books I have published. I have 30 plus years of experience in engineering education. I am teaching mechanical engineering subjects. These are all the books I have published earlier. Design of transmission system, turbo machines, heat and mass transfer, operations research, gas dynamics and jet propulsion, thermal engineering, fluid mechanics and machinery. And I have a YouTube channel where I uploaded the video lectures of all the subjects. Presently, I am uploading the solution for the gate question paper in the mechanical engineering. So, you can share the information to your students for their better learning. So, what is active learning? Why the active learning in the classroom? So, today the student, they can learn better by doing activity, by doing something inside the classroom. So, in our regular teaching, so instead of completely presenting 40 minutes or 50 minutes in chalk and talk or PPT, we have to combine, we have to involve the student in the learning activity, then only the learning will be effective and useful to the students. So, we have to incorporate active learning technique inside the classroom. First, let us define what is active learning. Active learning is anything course related that all the students in a class session are called upon to do other than simply watching, listening and taking notes. So, when you deliver a lecture using chalk and talk or PPT, they will just simply watching, listening and taking notes. So, in addition to that, other than that, they have to do something inside the classroom. That is what active learning. Bonwell and Eisen, 1991, they defined involving student in doing things and thinking about what they are doing. It is what active learning. So, this is another definition. Active learning engages the students in the process of learning through activities or discussion in the class, as opposed to passively listening to an expert. So, it emphasizes higher order thinking skill and often involves group work. So, the higher order thinking skill, it is what in the Bloom's taxonomy, analyze, synthesis and create, higher order. So, and apply also we can consider to some extent it is considered higher order. So, by involving the students in the activity, so the higher order thinking skill will be, there will be emphasis on the higher order thinking skill. So, as a teacher, so you are doing active learning in your class when you ask a question during your lecture session, pose a problem to the student, issue some other type of challenge other than the teaching, you are giving some other type of challenges to the student. Tell your student to work individually or in a small group to come up with a response and give them some time to do it. Stop them, you do all the administration about the activity. Call on one or more individual or group to share the responses. So, you make call the student to the stage and ask him to explain a concept or something for a few minutes. So, that is, if you do all these things, you are doing active learning inside the classroom. You are not doing active learning when you lecture, ask questions that the same few students always answer, or conduct discussion that engages only a small fraction of class. So, when you continuously lecture and you open a question, to throw a question, only the few students they are responding, and in the discussion only fraction of the class is participating. So, we have to ensure that everybody is participating in the lecture. the active learning techniques, the various techniques I have listed some 15 here. Think, pair, share, concept test, think aloud, pair, problem solving, brainstorming, visible quiz, student team achievement divisions, 1 minute paper, note check, writing assignment, active cooperative learning, ACL, jigsaw, problem based learning, collaborative learning, project based learning, round robin. So concept test, the test what we conduct, that is also a concept test. So we can do something interesting in the concept test. You can give group test. And the 1 minute note check, it is very simple. So the fellow student in the same desk, the fellow student can check the notes of the other student. So wherever there is a missing, they have to inform to the individual or to the class teacher, and the class teacher will give the instruction to rectify the mistake or mismatch information. So I will explain few of the activity here. First activity, think, pair, share. It was first formulated by Frank Lehman, 1981. Think about the question. Every individual student will think about the question, and they will pair, so they can join with the neighbor to discuss their thinking with their partner to enhance the thinking, to improve the answer. Then they will share their answer to the entire classroom. That is what think, pair, share. So you pose a question, the individually they will think, they will respond to your question, and they will join with the neighbor, they will discuss the solution, and if there is any improvement, they will share and improve, and finally they will present the information to the entire audience, entire classroom. That is what think, pair, share. And think, the instructor pose a question, preferably one demanding analysis, evaluation or synthesis, and give students 30 seconds or 1 minute or more time. 1 minute or 2 minute, even 1 minute you can give maximum, to think through the appropriate response. They have to come out with their solution for the problem or the question. Then pair, the students then turn to the partner. So neighbor is the partner. So in the same desk, another student is sitting, share their responses, thus allowing time for both rehearsal and immediate feedback on their idea. They can share, if there is mistake, they will discuss and rectify the mistakes. So it promotes the communication among the students. Then share, during the third and the last stage, student response can be shared with the learning team. So you can call upon one of the team and one of the student to share their findings, share their solution with the entire classroom. That is what the think, pair, share. So this can be very much applicable for theoretical subject, theory subjects. So when you are teaching a theory subject, you can give, when you are giving a concept, you can use this activity for better learning of the student. Visible quiz. So this can be effectively used as an activity for 5 minutes in between. So you can have some two questions maximum, three questions maximum. So you can give a break to the students. In the break of 5 minutes, you can conduct the quiz, but you have to properly plan with the help of PPT, or suppose the PPT facility is not available, you have to use the chalk and board for effective presentation of the visible quiz. So present your topic with the lecture notes, ask the student to go to form team, give time to discuss on the topic and get things clarified, present the quiz question on one by one, ask the individual to answer, no discussion with the team member, evaluate and find the individual score and team score. That is what the visible quiz. This will be very useful for theory paper again. Brainstorming. So this is normally we find in all the group discussion, in all the corporate interview, corporate discussion, they are conducting the brainstorming. So the same thing we can replicate in the classroom atmosphere. So brainstorming is a method of for generating idea to solve a design problem. So project work, you can adopt it, you can use this technique. It usually involves a group under the direction of the facilitator. So theory class also you can use the brainstorming session. The four general rules of the brainstorming. There should be a facilitator. So, usually involves a group under the direction of a facilitator. The teacher is the facilitator here. The four general rules of the brainstorming. Establish with an intention. There should be a specific topic on which all the discussion will revolve. Reduce this social inhibition among the group members. So, it should not be diverted by the group member. Stimulate idea generation. Increase overall creativity of the group. So, these are all the general four rules and advantages. Free thinking environment, broadening the solution space, improve the critical thinking of the individual and problem solving skill of an individual and the team, that will improve. These are all the advantages of the brainstorming. This you can very much use for theory paper. 1 minute paper. So, this can be used at the end of the lecture. So, every lecture, at the end of the lecture, you can give a piece of paper, off sheet to the student, or you can ask the student to take off sheet. So, you can give 1 minute paper is very commonly used classroom assessment technique. It really does take about a minute, and while usually used at the end of the class, it can be used at the end of any topic of discussion. Its major advantage is that it provides rapid feedback on whether the professor's main idea or what the students perceived as a main idea are the same. So, what you can do? You can give the instruction to the student to take a paper and write what they have understood from the lecture very well and what are all the confusing points and what are all not clear, very not clear. So, they can ask them, you can ask them the 3 points. What is very, very much clear? What is confusing? What is not clear? What are all the points not clear? So, you can collect all the paper under 3 headings, you can collect all the paper. So, you can consolidate, read, consolidate and give the feedback and give the answer to the in the next class. So, that will help the learning of the student and that will help the student, I mean the teacher, the responsible, actually the students will respect the teacher very well because you are expressing the concern to the student's learning. So, they will respect you very well. Think aloud pair problem solving, TAPS. So, this can be very much applicable for problem solving, problem subject to solve problem in the classroom. Useful in problem solving, understanding case studies or text. Have the students get into pair and designate one pair member as explainer and another one as a questioner. So, there are 2 members in every team. One person is explainer, another person is questioner. Give the explainer a minute or 2 to explain the problem statement line by line to the partner and tell the questioner to ask questions when the explanation was unclear and incomplete and to give hints when necessary. Stop the students after the allotted time and call on several individuals to explain things to you. So you can give few minutes time to the explainer and the questioner to share their, to explain, questioner to question, then you call any one of the team, any one of the class member to come on to the stage and explain things. Once you get satisfactory explanation, you have the pair reverse role and continue with the next part of the problem solution or case study, case analysis or text. So, once this first team is effective, then in the next problem, the questioner will be the explainer and the explainer will be the questioner. So, you can reverse their role so that it will give equal opportunity for the student to play the each role. Note check. Students work in pair. Summarize notes and locate misconception. Fill the gap in their notes. Approximately it will take 3 minutes. You can do at random in the classroom. Student Team Achievement Division, STAD. So, this is also a powerful technique in the solving problem. STAD stands for Student Team Achievement Division. It is a collaborative learning strategy in which small group of learners with different level of ability work together to accomplish a shared learning goal. So, different level of ability, that team formation is very critical here. It was devised by Robert Slavin and his associate in Johns Hopkins University in 2009. Students are assigned to 4 or 5 members learning team that are mixed in performance level and gender. The teacher presents a lesson and then the students work together with their team to make sure that all the team members have mastered the lesson. So you present a lesson and the team member, they have to work together to discuss and share and get clarified all the concept they are mastering on the particular topic of the lesson. Finally, all the students take individual quizzes on the material, at which time they may not help one another. Students' quiz scores are compared to their own past average and the points are awarded to the on the basis of the degree to which students meet exceed their own earlier performance. You can write the individual score. These points are then summed up for the team score. So this is the technique. So learn together in your team member, in your team, they will learn together and individually they take quizzes. The response of the students is marked, individual score is calculated and then the group score is calculated. So that is what the STAD technique, and this is used for solving problem. Jigsaw, this is another cooperative learning technique. Jigsaw is cooperative learning structure applicable to team assignment that calls for expertise in several distinct areas, problem solving, concept learning. Split the concept into different part and distribute to the students. So for example, you have a theoretical concept, a theoretical procedure or some explanation for some circuit, everything. You can split into different part. So each part will be given to individual students. The students of part 1 are called expert team. So there will be different teams. One group of students, they will be having part 1. Another group of students, they will be having part 2. Third group of students, they will have the part 3. So they will study all the students, whoever is having part 1, they will discuss. They are called as expert team. They will read, understand and become expert on that part. Similarly, other team. Then forming learning team comprising students from each part of the concept, the team member will explain the part to their member. So everybody in the team will learn the concept. I think this diagram will explain you. So we have four part of the problem split into four. The concept is split into four part. So in the four part, every part is given to four students individually. So there will be group one. Expert group 1, so they will, expert group 1, so the 4 members are there, each member will have the part 1, so they will discuss among themselves, they will discuss about the part 1 and will become expert. Similarly, part 2, part 3, part 4. Then we form the learning group 1, 2, 3, 4. So in each learning group, there will be one expert member from each part. So the entire concept split into four parts and the four parts will be discussed among the four learning group members, and there will be everybody, all the 16 people will be learning the entire topic. That is what the expert group and the learning group. So this is the jigsaw activity. Divide the student into 5 or 6 person in jigsaw groups. Appoint one student from each group as a leader. Divide the day lesson into 5 to 6 segments. Assign each student here to learn one segment. Give students to time, read over the segment at least twice and become familiar with it. Then form temporary expert group having one student from each jigsaw group to join together. Other students assigned to the same segment. Bring the students back into the jigsaw group. Ask each student to present their his or her segment to the group. Float from the group to group, observing the process. At the end of the session, give a quiz on the material to evaluate their understanding. So this is the jigsaw, which will be useful for concept learning or problem solving. Active cooperative learning, ACL. Active cooperative learning is an educational approach that promotes interaction among students and shared responsibility of academic achievement. So this is given by the Stein and Hurd in 2000. So this is how you have to plan the active cooperative learning. Team cooperative learning procedures are designed to engage students actively in the learning process through inquiry and discussion with their peers in small group, Davidson and Wascom in 1992. So they will form in a group, cooperate among themselves and learn. So this kind of team learning will collaborate, communicate and create. So this gives the collaboration among themselves, communication among themselves, and it will promote the creation of new concepts in the team. So the Boogie-end model, so this method we can very much adopt for lecture teaching inside the classroom. So once you prepare the notes for presentation, then you have to plan the activity, plan the delivery of the lecture inside the classroom with this pattern. First, advance the organizing. Second, 10 to 12 minutes lecture, 3 to 4 minutes turn to partner. Again, 10 to 12 minutes lecture, again 3 to 4 minutes turn to partner, and 10 to 12 minutes lecture, and finally, summary. Advanced organizing, so initially 1 to 2 minutes in the classroom, you can conduct an activity to bring the student to make attentive to the classroom. So you can have activity like brainstorming in the advanced organizing. Then you can present your notes for 10 to 15 minutes about the topic of the discussion today. Then after 15 minutes, you can have some quiz program in between. So that will give a break to the students in the quiz program. So you can evaluate the learnability or learning effectiveness of the learning of the student. Then you can go to the next presentation of 15 minutes. Again, you can have a quiz. At the end, you can have the 1 minute paper. So this kind of planning should be required for effective presentation of the topic for better learning of the student. The features of active learning. It creates greater student interest and motivation than traditional lecture. It involves the student in the learning process activity rather than passive listening. Provides more frequent and immediate feedback to the student. So every activity you can give the feedback for their improvement. Promotes development of student skill in critical thinking. Improves writing and the speaking skill of the student. Increases individual accountability. You are responsible. The students are made responsible for learning. Promotes greater academic achievement, breadth and depth of the achievement. Students learn to think about the subject and the topic. Provides students with an opportunity to think about, talk about and process the course material. Improves recall of information. Contributes to more favorable attitude towards learning. Places more emphasis on the teachers becoming a designer and facilitator of learning experience rather than an imparter of knowledge. Instead of teaching, continuously teaching, you can design and facilitate the learning experience of the student. Emphasize student-centered learning. Develops expertise in collaborative learning and teamwork. So it creates a sense of community in the classroom through increased students-to-student and instructor-student interaction. The relationship, human relationship inside the classroom will be better. It creates opportunity for differentiated instruction. So reinforces important material, concept and the skill. Address different students' learning style. It creates personal connection to the material for student, which increases their motivation to learn. Allows students to practice important skills such as collaboration through pair and group work. Builds self-esteem through conversation with other students. So these are all the benefits of active cooperative learning. So we design the active learning inside the classroom and help the student to learn better for their future. Procedure for implementing active learning in the classroom. Select a topic or subject content. Select suitable activity. So based on the subject requirement, you can select the activity. Plan for the requirement and arrange. Suppose if you want to conduct the activity in the seminar hall, you take the student to the seminar hall. Check the availability, if you want the PA system, check the availability, all the infrastructure required for active learning, you have to prepare. inform the students about the activity and it is important. So we have to inform them in advance so that they will prepare for the activity, conduct the activity, assess the activity, write down the problem faced by the faced and the challenges. You can immediately write the problems and the challenges. Write down the method to overcome the challenges. Share the outcome of activity to the student. Document properly for the future use. And I present a small case study. So what I have conducted for the heat and mass transfer subject for the 6th semester mechanical engineering A and C section, each section 45 students. The topic taken is heat exchanger. It is conducted on 19 to 2020. Between 10 a.m. to 12 noon. So, in the venue is seminar hall. And the A section, there are 45 students, 40 students were present. C section, 44 students, 42 students were present. So, number of teams is 14 in each class, 3 members per team. And we have to give instruction to the students about the team formation, team behavior, and general code of conduct. Team formation, so we have to be very careful. In every team, at least there should be one above average student, so that the above average student will help other two students to learn better. So there should be usefulness. You have to identify the team. So there should not be all the three students are very good or all the students are very bad. So there should be distribution of the students. So that is what team formation. The teacher, we have to take care of the team formation. And this is the question paper prepared well in advance and get ready many number of copies. So we are given 5 problems. They have to solve all the 5 problems in the 2 hours time. And this is how they are working inside the seminar hall, in the seminar hall in team. And we monitor the students' performance. Wherever there is a help required, we go and support them, help them to solve the problem. And this is how they are working in the seminar hall, each group of 3 members. And this is the performance of the student. Maximum mark is 50, minimum mark to pass is 25, number of teams passed A section out of 12 out of 14, C section 11 out of 14, individual team score A1 41, 37, 48 out of 50, 44, 40, 27, 17. 48, 43, 39, 30, 47, 12, 28, 42, 44, 31, 0. Unfortunately, that student, the team members, everybody performed very poorly. 35, 30, 30, 27, 22, 31, 36, 25, 44, 20. This is the score. Then we do the analysis. Highest score of A section 48, C section 44. Lowest score of A section 12, C section 0. Average is a score, A section 36, C section 30, number of teams scored above average score, 9 student in each, 9 teams in each section, number of teams scored below the average, 5 teams in each section. So this is the analysis for our study and improvement and report. Once the instructions were given about the role, what is expected from them, they were calm and focusing on the problem solving. They were actively discussing and solving the problem. I went around and assisted them when they asked doubts. The number of teams scored below average is 10, about out of 23. Out of 28, I am told 28. Once they understand the power of peer learning, they can do better. So few students who were absent regularly in the class are combined and good students to learn from them. And this is the feedback from the students. I told the student, we give the paper, test paper also we supply. So at the end of the paper, the students were asked to write the feedback. This is what the feedback given by the student. This type of activity improves the team working. It helps us to improve our leadership quality. This activity helps us to share our knowledge with one team member. By solving the problem with the team, we can cross-check the values easily. By working as a team, we can reduce the time to do the problem. Need more practice on unit conversion. So, the feedback. So, somebody give the negative feedback. So, they want practice. Useful in revising the topic. Got clarity in the procedure of how to solve the problem. I consolidated all the important feedback point. This type of activity improves our team working. It helps us to improve our leadership quality. This activity helps us to share our knowledge with the team member. By solving the problem with the team, we can cross-check the values easily. By working as a team, we can reduce the time to solve the problem. Useful for revising the topic. Got clarity about the procedure, how to solve the problem. It is helpful to slow learners to clarify their doubts. Easy to clarify the doubts. Group interaction improved while discussing. Presentation of data is improved. Helps to remember the formula for the group member. Easy for exam preparation. So, thank you. So, you plan your activity, some of the activity for your teaching subject, and promote learning among the students. So, if you have any queries, you can write to my mail ID. I am interested to share my experience and thought with you. Thank you once again.